Hello, peoples of YouTube. My name, as you should know, is Rambo, coming back with a new and improved video. And I know I haven't posted in 3 weeks. I posted up my top 10 other favorite TV shows today, which I recorded on Friday, what I was meaning to, but I got lazy again. So you know how that works, because when Rambo gets lazy, it's never really a good thing. Yeah, I know, my parents always get mad at me when I don't really play video games that much, because, you know, they buy them and all, so yeah, I play them. You know, I just want to let them know I still play them. So I haven't heard from you guys in a while, and plus I know you guys haven't heard from me in a while. I'm gonna go a little bit more in-depth tonight. I just stopped watching the Frank Sinatra 100th anniversary. It's his birthday coming up on the 12th, which is in about a week from now, since today is the 6th, and his birthday is the 12th. If you guys don't know, a lot of people tend to notice, actually, now, because a lot of my friends ask, like, why do you like so much old music? Well, you know, mostly Chicho, by the way, asked me why do I like old music, and very simple, I feel it's always better than new. And I was watching the 100th birthday special for Frank Sinatra, set up by Mr. Seth MacFarlane, who is an ultimate Sinatra fanboy, if I should say so myself. I don't think much of Seth MacFarlane, because if you remember in my modern stand-up comedy rant, or what I like to call philosophical talk, but that was more of a rant. And honestly, he did great. They all did great. Everyone who did the songs did very amazing. And I have to say, a lot of people aren't very good fans of covers, and I'm not always a fan of covers as well. But I do like Frank covers, if they're well made. Now, they had, you know, a lot of artists. They had Tony Bennett, who was a good friend of Frank Sinatra. They had a bunch of people. They had a John Legend. They had Celine Dion, who is actually one of my other favorite singers, and what I kind of like to call jokingly one of the reasons I love Canada. They also had Carrie Underwood, fellow Okie. Hi there. They had a lot of people. They had a lot of people, even singers that I like. They had Nick Jonas from the Jonas Brothers. That was hilarious. I thought that was funny. And they also had Lady Gaga. That was kind of weird. There were some that were really cool, but there were some that were just, wow, they could have done better. But, you know, that's still pretty good. And Seth MacFarlane's performance of One for My Baby was kind of, he could have done a little bit better, but, you know, whatever. Everyone has their different styles. He still made it work. And, honestly, I have to say, that was one of the best covers of Frank Sinatra songs I've ever heard. And I've heard a lot of them. And some of the best Frank Sinatra covers I've ever heard of, if I should suggest any, would probably be either Michael Bublé or Robbie Williams. So yeah, go check them out. People, I'm just going to say this right now. Frank Sinatra has influenced many people. Have influenced people, singers, anybody. I'm just a writer. That's what I do. But music is a core inspiration for that art form that I do. And I have no intention of going to music. I really don't want to do that. I mean, that's just, no, I don't want to do that. That just doesn't sound fun to me. Like, I mean, it would just get kind of, yeah, it'd be fun for a little bit. And I'm like, yeah, I want to do something I really want to do. And so, you know, writing stories is better for me. And I don't really rhyme. So, yeah, no, I'd be a terrible songwriter. But, Frank Sinatra really is a phenomenal singer. Like, no one would sing like he did nowadays. Like, I'm just saying, a lot of people would never do that nowadays. Like, you know, there's a lot of people who can try, but you just can't do it. It's impossible. So, you know, a lot of people have been influenced by this one man. Just think about it. You know, man, just think about it. Amy Winehouse and even the rapper Logic is influenced by this man, is one of the core influences by this man, and he's also one of mine. And why I'm not a musician or anything. I don't plan on becoming a singer, a musician, whatever. I don't plan on doing that. But I will say, being a writer, his stuff gives me inspiration. I haven't listened to Frank in a while. It's been a while before tonight that I started listening to him again. And that's honestly because, you know, his birthday's coming up, and I just remembered it a couple days ago. I told my mom and dad, I told, hey, mom, hey, dad, it's Frank Sinatra's birthday coming up, and I'm gonna, you know, wish him happy birthday. I'm gonna make a video, basically. You know, I'm gonna make up stuff on Wattpad about it, because, you know, that's what I've been doing for the past 3 weeks. If you're wondering why I've been gone, I've been, incognito, pretty much, meaning I've been writing more than I've been YouTubing, you know, because I can't do two things always at once. And, you know, it's not always my type of, you know, gig, and, you know, it's just, that's just how I roll. That's just how it works, pretty much, and it's not always the prettiest, but, you know, whatever. But anyways, so I'm just gonna go over, you know, I'm just gonna say right now what I really do feel for Frank Sinatra, and I've only listened to him for just a little while, probably 6 years. My dad originally liked him, and my uncle also originally liked him, so yeah, shout out to my uncle, shout out to my dad. Which my dad's in there, so I can just, you know, yell, hey, Dad, thanks, man, or whatever. And my, you know, my dad really was a fan, and my dad, he likes him, yeah, you know, not always the, you know, biggest fan. My uncle is, you know, a bigger fan of Frank Sinatra than my dad is. So, but mainly it was my dad, my uncle, that got me into Frank Sinatra, and, you know, got me into his whole, just music. You know, and his music is beautiful if you ever listen to it. It's very soothing. If you ever want to listen to someone truly great and, you know, truly amazing, just listen to this man. I could say anything I want about this guy because he's so just flat out amazing. Just flat out great and just so life-changing. That's how powerful his music can get. It's just, it's a life-changing experience. It's just, you people have not been enlightened. If, you know, I know a lot of you probably don't know, and, you know, and I like more modern stuff, too. It's just, I tend to like older stuff more. You guys know that, because a lot of you apparently pay attention to what I like on YouTube. Yeah, literally, it's on Twitter for some reason. I don't want to put it on private, though, because I actually kind of like it like that. But whatever. Honestly, though, I could say whatever I want about Frank Sinatra. I could say, you know, he's a great guy. I mean, I don't know him, but, you know, he's a great singer, great, you know. But it's kind of like Lost in The Walking Dead. Just not TV show when it's not so sad all the time. His music is so much more than it's just old. No. It just can't be. No. I refuse to believe that. It's just not what I consider possible. Because that is not what I think Frank Sinatra is. Because Frank is so much more than what people say he is. And people say he is, you could say whatever you want about him. You could just say, oh, he is a good singer, you know, but he isn't as, to me, he is the greatest singer of all time, and no one can do what this man did. This man was the Justin Bieber of the 1940s, 1950s, 60s, all the way to when he died in 1998, to when he passed away. And no one now could do something like what he did. No one can go for that long and still be in top shape, still can get that whole, you know, music in, and still can do anything he wanted. You know, he can still just move on. You know, you can't just, no, okay, let me just say that. Let me just say this. No one could do what this man did. And I know I've just said that a couple times, but I could say that right now. You could try and make music that could be influential for decades, but you cannot do what this man did. And that is, he made people look in awe and scratch their heads in awe for years decades, for almost 40 to 50 years. I can't just put this in a 10 to 20 minute video. I just can't do that. It's impossible, almost, because I can't describe how much this man has influenced me and influenced others. I just can't. I could. I wished I could, but I can't. And I'm not going to make a 45-minute video. I'm going to try not to. I'm going to make this as short as possible. Now, I'm not just going to say he's a great singer and I love this guy's music, which I do, but I'm going to say he is a lot more than meets the eye. And a lot of people could say that. A lot of people... Hi, Mom. Interrupting my video. Sorry, they kind of ruined that. My mom came in. But anyways, again, I could go so much, 8 hours probably. That's how much I like this singer. That's how much I really like this singer. But let me just get past why I think he's so much more than what people could say he is. This dude is the coolest guy you could ever meet, probably. If I ever met this guy, which, again, he's dead now, unfortunately he had passed away, he would probably be really cool. He would probably be really cool to meet, you know, he sounded like a very interesting guy from what people said about him and what people would think, and it was very, just, it's always the saddest thing to see. You know, people kind of go away. And this man never knew how to go away. Because he always came back. And I always loved how, you know, he never stayed away. He would always come back. He would always come back in shape. He'd always come back in style. And he never ceased to disappoint. That was always his intention. He never wanted to disappoint people. Even if you listen to some of his, you know, oh, not always the greatest music, it's still great, it's still amazing, and why it's so much more is that this man, you could ask any artist, you've probably heard of, you know, John Legend, Keith Urban, U2, or Bono, if you haven't heard of U2, you have a problem. I'm just saying, because I like U2. That's kind of a weird thing to say, that I just realized, that just sounded weird. I like some Lady Gaga. She's kind of weird still, but that's what everyone thinks. And Amy Winehouse, anybody. You could ask anybody who, even the guy from Panic at the Disco. I know a lot of you guys probably know who Panic at the Disco is. The guy from Panic at the Disco was in, he even said it himself, he was influenced by Frank Sinatra. And a lot of people are influenced by Frank Sinatra. Don't get me wrong. Just, you know, Amy Winehouse, for crying out loud. The late Amy Winehouse, God rest her soul, is very unfortunate what happened to her. And, it's kind of funny how I said that. Okay, never mind. Nothing sad, nothing's happy about this. But a lot of people have been influenced by this man. Let's just say that right now. And a lot of people have looked up to this guy, including myself. And I can never say anything that could move you or move him enough that this man could know. Because sometimes I would love to just let these people know what they personally mean to me. And I sometimes feel like I fail. I realize sometimes I might actually kind of fail at doing that. I don't like thinking of it that way, but I sometimes kind of think of it in that sense that, you know, I want to let these people who've influenced me know what they have meant to me over all this time. And it's very sad to see. And I always find it very sad. And this man has influenced my life, has influenced how I do things, how I represent myself, how I write, how I do my career, how I write, how I do my creative juices. This man has influenced a lot. I named a poetry collection after this man. That is how much he has influenced my life. And Frank really is just a standout guy. Honestly, if you ever listen to this man's music, you can't help but like it. Now, you might be bored of it at first. Like, I was never, because I grew up around old music. I bet a lot of people grew up around old music, because I know people who still listen to, like, classic rock and all that stuff. But Frank Sinatra, you can't beat that. And to me, you can't beat that, because he comes up with such pretty and such moving music. And, you know, none of it was original. All of it was sang before by other people like Louis Armstrong, Nat King Cole, and all these other great singers. And, you know, people who, you know, musicians, and, you know, Carrie Underwood's performance, I forgot what the song is called, but it's the second one she did after Fly Me to the Moon, or no, not Fly Me to the Moon, Let's Fly to the Moon, I think. It's, okay, I'm sorry, I know I'm the big Sinatra expert guy, because that's what I do, but, I seem to have forgotten. Yeah, no. But, Carrie Underwood's song, the second one she said, Let's Fly to the Moon. And, that was just beautiful. That is happy tear worthy right there. That makes you want to cry. Trust me. You can go back and watch it. I think it'll air on again, but that'll make you cry. I bet it'll go on YouTube tomorrow, but, like, it makes you cry, man. That song is just, man. Man, that is just, that is powerful, man. It's just, that's what Frank can do. And, you know, that was actually, that song wasn't even a Frank song. That was just, like, women Frank Sinatras, as I like to call it. People who sang the same genres, you know, Frank Sinatra. That's kind of what, you know, that's kind of one of their songs. But most of it was Frank Sinatra. I love Nick Jonas's performance of In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning, because I actually got the album in the Wee Small Hours. God, that was, man, that was good. Like, everything was good in that moment. Everything was good in that moment, I thought. And that's very rare. And, you know, everyone was good. And that is amazing. And again, I don't think much of Seth MacFarlane. I don't really respect the man that much, but I will say he did amazing, and I can tell he did appreciate Frank Sinatra enough to put that thing together. And I'm gonna get to the part that I wanted to get into, is what he personally means to me. Frank Sinatra saved my life, probably. And others, don't get me wrong, you know, there are a lot of other people who, you know, have saved my life, like my family, friends, all these other really great, even you guys helped save me, but I was in a really down place in 2014. I was in a very down place in 2014. I didn't want to open up about it, because, you know, that was sort of my thing, and I didn't want to open up about it, because, you know, that's personal. Don't want to get into that. But I felt like crap for those types of times, and with the help of YouTube, and friends, and family, and this man right here, Mr. Sinatra, I probably would not be standing here right now. I probably would not be sitting here doing this commentary right now. I would probably be somewhere moping about my life, which sometimes I do. You know, I can do that. Anyone can. But this man made me better. And that's very, just, that's something you can really feel. And this man saved my life, I feel. Now, not the actual man. Like, he didn't just lend a hand, you know, go like, oh, here you go, my son. You know, not like that. You know what I mean. You know, metaphorically, his music saved my life. And this man is just so damn interesting and so good that you just can't help but smile. And watching these other people show their appreciation to Frank Sinatra is very heartwarming to me. And that was one of the first times I've ever actually felt happy in a while. And, I'm happy when I'm around a lot of other things. I'm happy when I'm writing. I'm happy when I do a lot of other things. But I was truly feeling a sort of peace with myself when I watched this, because I know a lot of... Sometimes I even think about it, you know, is Frank Sinatra dead? Like, I know he's dead. Literally, I know he's dead, but is his music dead? I've always wanted to know that. I've always wanted to know, have people really, you know, forgotten about this man? Because this man is often regarded as one of the most, is one of the greatest singers in history, probably. I always wonder if people have forgotten who this man is. Have forgotten what this man can do. And forget what this man has done for music and for entertainment for almost 5 to 6 decades. I always wonder if people forgot about this man. And tonight proved that no one has forgotten about this man. And that was truly what touched my heart tonight about the Sinatra 100-year birthday special. It really showed me that people haven't forgotten about Frank Sinatra, and I hope that his music lasts for another million years. This man, what this man means to me is that this man influenced who I am and what I do. That's what this man has done, personally for me. He helped me, or his music did, help me go to a better place than where I was before. And yeah, there was a lot of other input in there, but his, that was a lot. And I had a very amazing journey for that sense with Frank and others, because there were a lot of factors in me getting better from that certain incident. And it certainly is beautiful seeing that other people feel the same way. They say, thank you for all those years of joy and happiness. Thank you, Frank Sinatra, for doing that. And I really do mean it from the bottom of my heart. I'm just going to make this really happy speech for you guys, because I love you guys and I love Frank so much. Not gay way, though. No, I'm just kidding. Not in a gay way. I really do like Frank Sinatra. His music is amazing. I know I've said that amazing. Okay, I'm going to stop saying that, because I ran out of things to say. I try not to ramble for too long, but I think I'm already doing it. I'm just going to say this. Mr. Sinatra. I'm not even going to call him Frank, because I don't know him that much. I don't know him at all, because I don't think he would have known me at all, because I'm a 14-year-old kid from Oklahoma, dude. Man, that don't come cheap, man. Oklahoma is a pretty nice place, though. You know, Frank, to me, has helped make me into who I am today. And I really do mean that. Frank Sinatra has made me into a new person. And it's kind of like that whole Christ sort of thing. He made me new. And, you know, now I'm not saying Frank Sinatra's Jesus, but I'm saying, you know, he kind of did help me in that sort of Jesus sense, that he helped me do a lot better with what I was doing. And he really did have amazing music. And I will say, thank you, Mr. Sinatra, for all the years of just pure amazement and joy and happiness that you will always bring to people like me and people like Amy Winehouse, who is unfortunately no longer with us. And people like Seth MacFarlane, who I don't really give a crap about, because I think his comedy is stupid, but aside from my personal bias of the man, I will say, you have influenced all of us, Frank, and I thank you so much for for everything you have done to make our lives just a little bit better. And I hope wherever you are, in a sense, and I know I always say this, but wherever you are, I hope you are experiencing such great joy. I really do mean it. And I'm just going to say this, and I don't know if people are going to think I mean it or not, but frick it. Thank you, Frank Sinatra. You have been an influence in my life, and I hope you keep influencing other people, other musicians, other just brands of people for thousands of years, millions or billions of years to come. I really do thank you. And really, you are amazing. And you will always be the greatest. I mean that. And I don't always call people the greatest. And because I've never always wanted to know, I've never really picked a great, my favorite, my personal favorite singer of all time. But this man will always be the greatest to me. That's me personally. So to Frank Sinatra, cheers to you, man. Wherever you are, or however many people you'll influence, I hope you keep doing it for millions of years, hopefully for eternity. Thank you, Frank Sinatra, for every minute, every second of every millisecond, I'm just getting a little weird now, of your joy, your happiness, and what you did, which was singing and making music. Thank you, Frank Sinatra. All right, I'm gonna go now.